Peep peep, blondes and alpacas, this is Livy, and this is another Speedart video. I know this design is a little more unique because it includes alpacas inside of a cup, or Cuphead's head, I should say. Well, it's because yesterday I was thinking about what to draw, and I was debating whether I want to do a Cuphead drawing or an alpaca drawing, so I decided to do both. And I thought, what if there were all these little alpacas just hanging out in his head? So that's what I did. And this is going to be one of the new designs for my shirts. Yes, I'm actually gonna get new shirt designs in my Redbubble. I will make a video about that whenever they're all ready. I have one more that needs to get ready, and then all of them will go into the shop and I will announce it. And why I decided to have new shirt designs now is because ever since Adam wore my shirt in his streams, my shop has been getting more attention, but also a lot of the shirts in my shops, like, nothing against the designs or anything, but a lot of them are very out of date. What I decided is to make some more updated designs and put them in the shop. And I've had some people like tell me they would love more updated designs that represent my channel right now instead of what it was when I started, because that's basically when I made those, is when I started. I was just so excited, and I was like, I'm gonna make shirts like right now. So yeah, that's what this shirt's design's going to be, and that's why there's no watermark, but that does not give you the excuse to take it without my permission and reselling it, because if you do, you will be in big trouble, and I am not kidding. So anyways, if you notice, like, I'm running out of air, and I'm not super energetic, because I am very, very tired. I'm struggling with really bad fatigue right now, and I'm just really wiped out. And also, last week I had a lot of tension, and I think all my energy went into that tension, made me all tired. I know I thought about this earlier, and I thought of the perfect wording, but I can't think of it right now. What's going on is why I like videos, like, I've been uploading like 3 times a week instead of 5 times a week. Well, because I want to work on other projects too, besides my YouTube videos. Like, there's a comic I'm working on, as you heard, my series Cuphead comic. I'm actually starting my second chapter of that comic right now, and I would like to work more on that, so I'm working on that. And I would like to do some other stuff with art, so I'm working on that too. And I thought of little, like, you know, fun crafts and everything. So yeah, I'm just getting things together, and again, I'm just really fatigued. I'm really tired. I don't have 100% energy. I'm actually having a hard time talking through this because I'm just so exhausted. But this one story I need to tell you guys, the story while this speed art happened. It's a short story, so I guess that's a good thing I rambled on before that to talk about this story. I've told Adam about this before, not the whole story, but I told him before, and I think if you guys were at his stream when I said this, that there was a time that a woman that worked at Dunkin Donuts insulted my voice. Yeah, I am not kidding. And yeah, this video is not sponsored by Dunkin Donuts. I don't want to take a dump on Dunkin Donuts, if you know what I mean by that. And actually, we have some Dunkin Donuts donuts downstairs, and they're really good. I had a cookie crunch donut. It has like cookie crumbs on the top, and it has like a chocolate peanut butter filling in it. It's really good. But the one thing I love at Dunkin Donuts is I love their coffee. If you know me very well, I always am drinking coffee. I don't eat breakfast. I just have a cup of coffee in the morning. That's my breakfast. And I have a cup of coffee after meals. I'm always seen most of the time with a cup of coffee, even at conventions. I will have like a Starbucks or the coffee from the hotel. I constantly drink coffee because it relaxes me. Believe it or not, it actually relaxes me. But yeah, Dunkin Donuts has really, really good coffee. And what's unique about their coffee is they have flavor shots, and they have all these different unique flavors. Like, they have strawberry, they have vanilla, they have almond, they have raspberry, they have chocolate, they have mocha. Not mocha coffee, like mocha flavoring, not the coffee, because those are two different items. Like, I think they have mocha too. I'm pretty sure Dunkin Donuts has mocha. Anywho, one order I like to get at Dunkin Donuts when I'm ordering coffee is I like to order a small coffee, because their small is just the right size. It is just the right size for coffee. A small coffee with a coconut and blueberry flavor shot. It is so good. It sounds very bizarre, like coconut and blueberry, are you serious? But I promise you, it is so good. And I remember a few years ago, they had Dunkin Donuts in the bag, the ground up bag of the grounds, and they had a strawberry shortcake coffee, and it is really good, but I could never find it again. That makes me very sad. I can't find it again, but I'll look for it. Maybe I can look for it online or something. But anyway, I'm starting to get off topic, getting into coffee, but yes. So I went into Dunkin Donuts. It was a Sunday. I had my coat on. I was in my Sunday best under the coat, so I was not wearing anything weird or anything like I usually do. There was only one customer in front of me who was a woman. I can't really judge how old she was because I didn't really study her that well, but I didn't study her at all. But the lady behind the counter, she was busy smiling and laughing, and the other employees, again, she was smiling and laughing with the other employees, and they're not her age either. This woman, she seems to be in maybe late 50s, middle age somewhere. Like, she looks like she's old enough to be a grandma, definitely. She looks like she could be a grandma, but anywho. But yeah, she was busy smiling and laughing, and I was like, she's in a good mood. And then it was my turn, and that smiling and laughing, as soon as I went up, turned into anger and disgust. Like, her face, like, just like in a snap, turned into, like, the smiling and laughing and happy into, what are you doing here type look. And I don't know this woman. I absolutely do not know this woman. And I was like, okay, like, what did I do that make you so upset? Like, and then, so I shrugged it off and I simply said, I would like to order a small coffee with a blueberry and coconut shot, please. And then she was like, what? I was like, okay. That was really rude how she asked me that, but one of my things that drives me insane when I go to restaurants, and I know I do have a speech impediment, and I do have a Pittsburghese accent, so mixed together, I have an ugly voice. I know I have an ugly voice, but sometimes when I talk, I constantly have waiters or waitresses or whatever repeat what I just said. It's annoying a little bit, like, and it hurts. It hurts. Like, I understand that they didn't understand me, but hearing it like all the time, like almost every time I order from a restaurant or whatever, I even remember the one time at school at the cafeteria, I ordered something and the lunch lady stood looking at me like, what the hell did you just say? And then I said, oh, I'm sorry, I'll repeat that. And she said, good, because I had no idea what you just said. And I was like, that was kind of rude. And even though the cafeteria ladies at my school were not the most friendliest people ever, they were quite rude. Well, anywho, so that was, like, unfortunately not out of the ordinary for me. So I was like, okay, so I said it a little bit louder and a little bit slower and softer. I know, louder and softer. I don't remember what, but I think I said it a little louder, but not, I wasn't screaming, but I did say it a little bit louder. I said, I would like a small coffee with blueberry and coconut flavor shots, please. And then this is what she said. I had never had anybody say this to me before. This is what she said, and I couldn't think of any other word except flabbergasted of what she said to me after this. This is seriously what she said after I said that. She said, talk right. I was talking right. That was my voice. I remember I was standing there in disbelief. It's like, did you just insult my voice? Like, this is my normal voice. What do you mean talk right? Like, I'm not talking like a toddler. I'm not talking like a boy. Like, I know I sound like a boy, but I'm not trying to talk like a boy. And I'm not doing my cartoon characters or video game characters. Like, I'm not doing Cuphead. Oh, Mugman. No, I'm just being Livy. And she told me to talk right. It's like, what the hell does that mean? Talk right. I was just, I didn't know how to react. I was just standing there and I've never been so insulted by an employee at a an establishment, I guess you could say, because I understand that, you know, being a cashier or being a waiter or a waitress or working at like a store is not the dream job that everyone wants. Trust me. Trust me, my brother used to work at McDonald's and he hated it. And I heard so many horror stories about, you know, what happened at work and everything. And I remember he even said that there was a girl that got fired because she gave her boyfriend a free drink. It's like, wow. Couldn't they just take it out of her paycheck or something? But no, they just fired her. It's like, wow. But oh my god, this woman insulted me. Like, I've had, like, you know, rude cashiers, rude waiters or waitresses, again. But this woman downrighted insulted me. She gave me this evil look the whole time. Like, she was smiling and laughing, but as soon as she saw me, she gave me this evil look. I had no idea what it was about me. It was nothing that I was wearing because I was dressed in my Sunday best. And I even had a coat on. So she couldn't even see what I was wearing anyway. So that's not what she was so upset about. I had no idea what it was about me that upsetted this woman. And when she told me to talk right, I kind of wish I would have said, F you and just walk away, but you know, I would get into trouble for that too. So I just said, I don't remember how I actually said it, but I didn't even think I knew what to do. So I just said it again in my normal voice. I think that's what it is, because that it was my normal voice in the first place. I said, I would like a small coffee with a blueberry and coconut flavor shot, please. And then, you know, she finally rang it in, but she kind of gave me attitude about it. And then I gave her the money. She gave me the coffee. I went to the station the little station where they have like the sugars and the creamers and sweeteners. I put my sweetener in there. That's what I put in coffee. I put artificial sweetener in it. I know what you guys are gonna say, Livy, that's not good for you. But I don't drink sugar, sorry. Like, I don't really drink calories. I don't drink my calories. So I put sweetener in my coffee. And then I went to the car, and when we were driving off, we were already out of the little plaza that the Dunkin Donuts was in. It was a small Dunkin Donuts, by the way. It's not a big one, but it was a smaller Dunkin Donuts, maybe the size of a small Starbucks, or even smaller than a small Starbucks. It was pretty tiny. I took my sip of coffee. Bitch, she gave me lukewarm coffee. I was so mad. Like, on top of her, you know, being upset with me for no reason, on top of her insulting the way I talk, she gave me lukewarm coffee. Lukewarm coffee, like, one thing, I do not like cold coffee unless if it's an ice cream, but this is lukewarm coffee. That's about worse than cold coffee. And I was just so upset, so I just poured it out and threw it away. Because I'm like, I'm not dealing with her crap anymore. But I wanted to march in and say, hey, you gave me lukewarm coffee. But, oh, God knows what she would do next. Maybe she would probably grab me by the neck and throw me on the ground. I don't know. But luckily, I've never seen that woman again. And I never had a negative experience like that bad at a Dunkin' Donuts. Like, the other bad experience I had at a Dunkin' Donuts in that same year, which was last year, actually, was a man was kind of rude to me. But other than that, no. Other times, like when I go to Dunkin' Donuts, I would tell them that exact order and be like, oh yeah, sure, no problem. And I remember that one time I had to go to the bathroom really bad, and so I asked the cashier if she can hold my coffee while I go, and she's like, yeah, sure. And so I would. But this woman, she made fun of my speech impediment. She made fun of somebody with special needs. How dare you? And so very unprofessional. That is, I'm sorry, I'm just still quite mad about this, because I never had anybody that mean, not just rude, but mean to me. I'm just so flabbergasted by all this. That's the only word I can think about, because, and also when she first saw me, she got all upset. I'm to this day, I still don't understand what it was about me that made this woman upset. Like I said, I had a coat on, so she wasn't judging what I was wearing. I was in my Sunday best because it was Sunday and I had church in the morning. The only possible thing is that I had my ears pierced 5 times, but there's girls in there that have nose piercings and eyebrow piercings, and even some with tattoos all over their arms and necks. So, it can't be that. Again, I had no idea what it was about me that upsetted this woman, and that she was all happy and giggly to very mean and insulting. Just because I talk differently and I know I have an ugly voice, I know that. I'm not proud of that, but I know that for a fact that I do have a very boyish, ugly voice. But I can't help it. Like, I am from Pittsburgh, so I do have a Pittsburghese accent. And this is the Pittsburgh area, so a lot of people should have that. But also, I do have a speech impediment too, so mixing that together, it's, I guess that's not the best combination in the world. At least not for a girl. Hey, I'm sorry, I'm still very mad about that. But tell me in the comment section below, has anything like that has happened to you? Like, have you ever had, like, a waiter, waitress, cashier, anybody insult you like that? I hope not. I really hope not, because that was really unacceptable. And about this design, what do you guys think of it? A lot of peeps on Discord really liked this design and said they want to see that on a shirt, so that's what I'm doing. And the announcement for my shop, my new shirts in my shop, will be coming soon as the last design is made, which I'm still planning on it and working on it and everything. But leave a like, it is very well appreciated. Hop aboard Alpaca Bandwagon and subscribe and hit the bell for notification and to join that peep peep party. But this was Livy and this had been LivyNex. I'll see you next time, my friends, and see ya.